Hello everyone, welcome back. So in the last video, we have seen how we can give a tag to example table to run that, you know, change that data based on the different environment. In this video, we will see how we can change the environment or how we can manage environment. Suppose when you are working in a real-time projects, you'll have one application and a test. But the same application will be tested under different, you know, QA and prod and dev, right? So these environments you'll be testing and you'll have different URL for all these environment. What you do, application will be same, just URL will be different. So you can maintain all those URLs and your step will remain, every scenario will remain same. You just need to change, you should be able to change your environment at runtime from configuration file or from anywhere that you want to maintain it. So let's see how we can do that. For that, I've taken a very simple test. What I'm going to do here, because we don't have any application where I can show that, you know, with the same, you know, website, different environment, I could not find. So we'll take a very simple example of Google and Wikipedia. Suppose we have one Google as a SIT environment, and then you can Wikipedia as a prod environment or QA environment. Two example. We'll just try to change the run URL at runtime and see how the different URL we are able to hit from the command line. Now what happened? I've just taken here one scenario where I open the URL and I retrieve the title here. I'm not going to do any validation, just open the URL. Now I did not define any URL here in example table. Usually in real time, you don't mention your URLs here in the feature file. We have seen in the previous video, but that was just to showcase how to use example table. But when you work on in the projects, you will maintain all your URL related configuration in your this config file. If I'll show you here in configuration file, and if I scroll down to somewhere around, yep, here, base URL section, this is where you maintain your base URL. As of now, it is by default localhost was defined, but you can give your application URL here. For example, you have some application, what you can do, you can simply take this URL, paste it here, and just run from here itself. So now I am going to show you the first feature. We have already seen there is two step. I open the URL, I retrieve the browser title. Now for that, I have written a step here, very simple again. It maximizes the window and then it will open the URL. But if you see here, I have not defined any which URL to open, just slash. When you define only slash, then what automation it will try to find any URL is defined in configuration file or not. And we have defined here in configuration file. So if it is defined in configuration, it will take that URL here, it will append here, and it will open that. And next step will be, it will just retrieve the title. So when you run this code now, it will open the Google, and then it will just print the title of the page. So let's just try to run this and see if first this is working or not. So I'll go in configuration file, and because I don't want to run all this feature file, because we have multiple feature file. And if you see here in spec section, we have earlier seen the previous video as well. If you define like this, right, inside test, inside feature, any file with dotted feature for extension, it will find everything and it will try to run. But I want to target only specific this feature file. So I can just pass the name of that feature file, app env, and then once you save it and if you run now your command, it will run only. Otherwise, you can tag this feature file and based on the tag which we have already discussed in the last video. But for now, I just want to run only this feature, so I've added that feature name here. Now let's try to run this and see how it works first. So I'll say npm test, and it is from the command line, okay, cmd windows command line, and I'll say npm test. Let's see first what it does. It should open URL and it should print the title. So it's trying to run this our targeted feature file, appenv.feature. So window is maximized and it's trying to load Google application. You see, it loaded the URL. It will just close it because it's loading here. And just till completed, it will close down. So yep, it's done. Right, execution is completed and I'm just trying to print here application title, right? So the same should be, steps are passed, and if you see here, application title is Google. Now again, we have not defined any URL here, we have just said slash, What it does that it took the URL, whatever is defined in the configuration file in this base URL section, right? Now, what we can do if we have multiple environments for the same application, right? So I don't want to change my any steps or any feature file and provide the different. What you can do in configuration itself, this URL or any URL if you have, just scroll to the top. As of now, I'll try to show here in the same configuration file. Later in the videos, we'll see in another video how we can optimize this code, move this data, whatever I'm going to write code in separate file. But for now, let's maintain all our URL here. So I'll say I have dev environment as this, okay? And then I have QA environment as well, like Wikipedia. So I'll just copy this URL. Right, so I'm maintaining as of now two environment URL. One is for dev, one is QA. So if I, you know, I want to run in dev, it should open this URL and retrieve the title. If I want to run in QA, it should open this URL and it should retrieve the title. Right, now how we can change this environment based on this? So there is something called process.env in node. Okay, process.env in node. It helps you to read the environment variables at runtime from the command line that you pass. So what we will do, we can give any keyword, process.env dot anything you can give. You can anything, you can give ABC, but for, you know, meaningful name, I'll say capital ENV. This will be, this environment, if you pass anything E environment from the command line, it will be able to read it in this value. Now what I'll do before that, I'll create one variable here that app base URL. I'll say app base URL. Okay, that will be of string type. That is simple variable. Now what I'll do, I'll say condition here. In if condition, I'll write if process.env dot capital env is equal to, if you are passing dev dev from command line, then set this app base URL equal to this value. Okay, else if process.env equal to QA, then define app base URL is equal to QA. Now this dev and this dev is nothing but different. Okay, you can, instead of here dev, you can say Google. And instead of QA here, you can say Wikipedia for Wiki. And when you pass dev environment, dev as a environment variable, it should run open Google. And if you say QA, it should run this Wikipedia. You can give like this also, just to make it meaningful, okay? But for now, I'll just change it back, or let's keep it like that so that we don't have dev and dev confusion. So we are saying if you pass dev, then open, set base URL as a Google, that means this URL. And if you're passing env variable as QA, then set the app base URL as a this Wikipedia URL. Okay, now what if we don't pass anything? So, or if we pass the wrong data? So if you pass any wrong data, we want to just print, you know, some message in console and then close the execution. So what we'll say, console.log to print anything in the console, and I'll say please pass correct environment variable, and let's suggest also what and all we have. So we have what and all we can pass, dev, or we can pass QA, right? So if you pass anything, and then we'll stop the execution. So for that, you can say process dot exit, right? Now let's understand what we have written. What we are saying, we have defined multiple environment here. If you're in your application, you have multiple environment defined like this, give a proper name, you know, UAT, prod, QA, anything, and then create one variable, any variable here. Now just provide a condition that if you pass env variable from command line as dev, then set base URL, means this URL, as Google or your SIT or UAT or QA or anything. And if you pass environment as a QA, then set this as a base URL. Now this base URL variable, we will scroll back here where we have our this section. Now we'll remove the URL from here. Okay, from single quote also, it will be a variable name app base URL you'll define. We remove the actual URL. Now we are just saying app base URL, which will be this value, right? And this, how we are defining? Based on these conditions from the command line. If we don't pass anything, it will throw this message. And then now let's see how we can use this, right? So now, for example, for first time, I'll just, now you want to, you know, we, what we have to do, we have to set the environment for this variable. How we can set? From the Windows command terminal, you should say set set and this variable name. As of now, we have given env, so we need to see env only. If you have given abcd here, okay, abc, then you have to type here also set abc only, okay? Just make sure that you pass whatever you define here, you are passing that. But let me change back to env and I'll say here env, okay? And I'll pass anything random. As of now, we know that we have only two value accepted currently, dev and qa. But just to show you whether this else condition is working fine or not, I'll just pass anything, okay? Any random data. So I'm setting this variable, okay? And then that's it. Nothing you'll see here. Now you want to run your test. So to run a test, I'll say npm test. That is our command, npm test. It should throw me this error. It should, and it should not continue the execution. Let's see if that works or not. Yeah, so it did not execute. And if you scroll up here, see, this is the message which we have defined here. Please pass correct env variable, and then we are defining the option. So if you pass any wrong data, it will not continue the execution. It will stop here, and whatever you are passing here in console, it will give that, okay? And it will not continue the execution. Fine. So this else condition is working fine. Now let's see that whatever we have written here, steps, right? This steps is working fine or not, and we are able to change the environment. Now suppose I want to target my dev environment. So when we say dev, what should it should execute? Google. That means nothing but this URL. So if I set the environment variable as a dev, it should open a Google. If I set environment variable as QA, it should open a Wikipedia, right? So let me now again, first let me create the command line. Now if you want to set, you can say set env equal to, now let me pass this as a QA, okay? So I'll pass this as a QA now, okay? Environment is set. Now again, if you run now npm test, it should open this Wikipedia. And as we have, whatever you have run, you have written here steps, right? To retrieve the title and print the title. Let's see if it is printing the Wikipedia or not. Yeah, see, if you see, it is opening Wikipedia, right? It will load and it will retrieve the title and it will just close the execution. It opened and yep, it's completed. Let's see what title it retrieved. So if you see here, scroll up, application title, Wikipedia, right? So when we have passed environment variable as a QA, it opened Wikipedia, right? Now let's see, if I pass environment as dev, it should open Google. So now let me change the environment variable as dev and then run again a test. And this time it should open a Google and print the title of that. So now it's trying to open Google, if you see here, and should close the browser. Closed. Steps passed, and let's see what is the title, right? See, title. So that is how we are able to change. So what we did, let's just quickly recap. First things, we have created one sample feature. It was already created, I have just written. So this is a sample to open the URL, retrieve the browser title. The steps are here. So maximize the window and open the URL. Now we don't define any URL here in the step definition. So if you don't define, if you just say slash, it'll read from the configuration file. Now in the configuration file, usually the base URL will be in this section here, here actual URL. Now because we want to maintain multiple URLs, we moved our URL here and another URL. So we have maintained two URL here in this environment variable. We have created one more variable with app base URL of type of string. Now what we used here to read any environment variable from the command line, we have used process.env, which is available in Node.js. I'll leave the link in the description to read more about this environment variable. You can check out from there, but we can use this to read the environment variable. And this is our customized variable. You can say custom variable. You can pass anything instead of env. And if it matches dev, then open this Google URL. If it matches QA, then open Wikipedia URL. that we have seen and it is working fine. And if you pass any random data, it will print this message in the console and it will close the stop the execution then and there itself, right? So that's it for this video. And in next video, we'll try to explore synchronization or different weights available in WebDriver IO. Thank you so much.